Hi students, let us revise what we learned in previous class. So our topic was matter around us. So in that, what was matter? Matter is the smallest substance which is made up of smallest particles. For example, what are the materials we are seeing around us? These are the examples of matter. Now let us come to today's topic called diffusion. Diffusion, the movement of fluid from higher concentrated area to lower concentrated area. The particles will mix until they distribute uniformly. For example, we took the example of instant sticks. Whenever we are lighting an instant stick at a particular corner, it will reach the scent or the perfume will reach the other corner within a fraction of seconds. This is the best example for diffusion. So now we shall go for activity. Activity 1, diffusion of liquids and effect of temperature on diffusion. So for this, we need the materials 200 ml beakers, a stopwatch, test tubes, and KMNO, this is potassium permanganate solution. So here it is a potassium permanganate solution. And we are taking two test tubes. The two test tubes are half filled with water. And we have potassium permanganate crystals. Now, let us add some solution of potassium permanganate to the half filled water through the walls of the test tube. And let us take one more test tube, and in this also let us add a few drops of potassium permanganate. You can see here in test tube 1 and in test tube 2. In test tube 1 and test tube 2, which are equal in water, and we have added here 2 drops of potassium permanganate in 2 test tubes. Now, let us say whenever we increase the temperature of this potassium permanganate solution, what will happen to that solution? Let us heat the test tube. So whenever we increase the temperature of this solution, can see in test tube 1 the temperature was normal, whereas in test tube 2 the temperature has been increased. So we can see well here in test tube 1 when there was no temperature increase, the solution was not distributed evenly, and in test tube 2 whenever we have increased the temperature, the solution has been distributed in the water in uniform way. So from this activity we have observed that whenever a temperature increases, then the diffusion also increases. That means we can observe one thing here. The diffusion of potassium permanganate solution is faster when we are heating. Okay, in this activity, we have seen that in liquids, the diffusion is slower, but whenever we are increasing the temperature, then the diffusion will be faster. So in this experiment, whenever we are adding potassium permanganate to a water, potassium permanganate solution to water, the diffusion will take place slowly. But whenever we are heating or increasing the temperature of that solution, then the diffusion takes faster. So, next, let's go further activity. The particles of matter are very small. So, for this activity, we need materials, 5 test tubes, a beaker, water and potassium permanganate solution. The precautions are, handle the test tubes carefully. Next, let us go for the procedure. Take a potassium permanganate solution in a test tube, and I took nearly 5 ml of potassium permanganate in the test tube. Then I took 4 test tubes, half filled with water and a 4 test tube half filled with water. From the first test tube, I'm dropping a little amount of potassium permanganate to the walls of the first test tube. Can see here, this is the first test tube that we took potassium permanganate. So from this test tube, we are adding a little bit of potassium permanganate to the other test tube which contains water. So again from this solution, again we are adding this potassium permanganate solution to the other test tube, the second test tube. Can see here we are getting a little bit of pink color. Again from this test tube we are adding the solution to another test tube. Then we are getting light pink color. Again from this test tube we are adding this solution to another test tube. You can see here gradually we can see the change in the intensity of color. In first test tube it was dark pink color, then it has been little bit brighter, then again brighter, then again we are getting total brighter color. So from this activity, we have learned that the intensity of color decreases gradually. Here, the color was pink. In second case, it was lighter. Again, in third case, it was again lighter than the second case. And in last case, it is totally lighter than the previous color intensity. That means a crystal of potassium permanganate from a small crystal of potassium permanganate contains a very large number of particles. Then we have covered a concept here. Even small quantities of substances contains a large number of small particles. So let's go for further activities. Speed of diffusion in two gases. Here the materials required are 2 feet long graduated test tube, ammonia solution, concentrated hydrochloric acid solution, pieces of cotton, water, rubber gloves, etc. Now precautions, don't touch the acids with hands directly and while handling the materials be careful. Now observations and procedure. Procedure, we are taking a 2 feet long graduated test tube. In that we are inserting 2 cotton pieces, one is dipped in ammonium solution and other one is dipped in hydrochloric acid solution. At the two ends we are dropping a cotton pieces, 2 cotton pieces, one each contains ammonia solution and other one hydrochloric acid solution. And the help of 2 rubber cocks, close the ends of 2 test tubes, and we can observe that a white ring forms near hydrochloric acid solution. That is, H3 is reacting with HCl is forming, and it is forming NH4Cl, that is ammonium chloride. So it is forming nearer to hydrochloric acid solution. It is forming a white ring nearer to hydrochloric acid solution. Observations, NH3 gas moves faster than HCl solution. So we can observe clearly here, the white ring is forming nearer to hydrochloric acid solution. That means that ammonia is moving faster than the hydrochloric gas. Then here the concept covered is ammonia is diffused faster than that of HCl solution. So once again we are taking a 2 feet graduated test tube. At the two ends, we are putting two cotton pieces, one in MH3 solution and other one is HCl solution. And we are placing the two ends of test tube. With the help of two rubber cocks, we are closing the two test tubes and two sets. Then we can see that a white ring is forming here, HCl solution. That is, NH3 is moving faster than that of HCl solution. So we can see that the speed of diffusion in gases is faster. So, for our better understanding, let us take one more activity, that is your assignment. Activity, checking solubility of substances in water. Activity name is checking solubility of substances in water. For this, the materials required are water, sugar, table salt, sawdust, sand, chalk powder, clay, urea, coconut oil, glucose, test tube and test tube stand, and one more, a glass rod. Now go for the procedure. For example, take sugar and add the sugar in water. Take nearly 100 ml of water, distilled water, and add sugar in that 100 ml of water. With the help of glass rod, stir it carefully. If it is soluble, write a tick mark under soluble in water and an into mark in insoluble in water. For the same procedure, for table salt, sawdust, sand, chalk powder, clay, urea, coconut oil and glucose. So two more questions you will get. First one is, why do some substances dissolve in water and some substances do not? Question again I am repeating, why do some substances dissolve in water and others do not? Second question, why we are calling water as a universal solvent? Again one more time, why we are calling water as a universal solvent? So hope you understood better. So let us meet again with some lab activities. Thank you.